Peabody Ducks. Hello, Peabody Ducks. They have a little fountain so they can practice their swimming routine. And then here's the rest of their little duck palace. They have a nice little grass section, a place to crawl up.
The little hotel.
That's where they sleep. They sleep in the Peabody. Scale model of the Peabody.
Some grass, some big grass.
Some nice little Peabody ducks. Yep. Nice.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the Peabody, the South's Grand Hotel. Southern novelist David Cone once wrote that the Mississippi Delta begins here in the lobby of the Peabody Hotel and ends on Catfish Road down in Vicksburg, Mississippi. And then if one were to stand in this lobby, they too would be witness to everybody who is anybody passing through the Delta. And that phrase, ladies and gentlemen, is as true today as it has ever been. So the Peabody Hotel was first established back in 1869, just a couple blocks from here at Main and Monroe. In 1925, we expanded and relocated to here, 149 Union Avenue. Throughout all of our history, the Peabody has proudly served as that social center for the city of Memphis. After the Duck March, I do invite you to visit our memorabilia room. It's just up the white marble stairs here, beautiful plastic room above the gift shop, and there we have artifacts and stories unique to the Peabody's long history. For example, up there we have portraits of presidents and stars who graced our halls over these years. We have played host proudly to every sitting U.S. president since Harry Truman here at this hotel. We have up there a piece of Elvis Presley's original RCA contract, which was negotiated, typed, and signed here in this very lobby on our stationery, no less. But up there, ladies and gentlemen, we host my favorite artifact, a simple memo written by our general manager regarding the menu over at Chez Philippe, explaining what we can have. Absolutely no duck served on any menu here at the hotel. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're gathered, of course, to witness the march of the Peabody Ducks. But if you have not done so before, it may surprise you to learn that our whole tradition here got started with a practical joke. Back in 1933, our general manager, Mr. Frank Shunt, his friend took from hunting in Arkansas. And they had brought with them what was actually pretty common at that time to buy duck decoys to help them hunt. But the gentleman also brought them on this trip a bottle of Jack Daniel's. Now, admittedly, they focused a bit more on that whiskey. Right there around them. So they were surprised when they returned to the hotel and found they had forgotten to leave those three English call ducks back at the farm. So they improvised by sneaking the ducks into the hotel lobby and setting them loose into our fountain instead. Of course, deep dug. Gentlemen retired to their rooms for the night. When the general manager came down the next morning, all he was expecting were stories of the staff chasing ducks around the lobby, getting them out of the hotel, and the general covering up his mischief from the night before. But instead, he found the ducks had stayed in the fountain the entire night long, and what's more, a crowd of guests had gathered around and they were gawking at the ducks. And the general manager went over and apologized, said he did this cleanup right away, and people would never see ducks here at the hotel again. But those people protested. Said, no, they loved the ducks. Even insisted instead we should let them stay as our guests. So ladies and gentlemen, we've continued to honor your request, but we have had ducks as permanent residents at this hotel for over 80 years. Then in 1940, we hired a bellman, Mr. Edward Pembroke. And Mr. Pembroke was also a retired animal trainer for Wyoming Motors and Barnum & Bailey Circus. He told us, if given the opportunity, he could train our North American mallards to march across the rooftop, ride down the elevators, and then march down the red carpet into our lobby fountain every morning at 11 o'clock. And those who stay until 5 p.m. as he dusts them out of that fountain, march them back up the red carpet, up the elevators, and back to their rooms. All this done to music, no less. I proposed that to management, and they were skeptical, obviously. I told them that if he could figure all that out, I'd let him march ducks for as long as he'd like. So Mr. Pembroke went on for that day to train and march ducks in this here at Peabody for the next 50 years. He also knew the ducks all across the country. They were on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson, featured in People magazine. He and the Ducks even made a very special guest appearance on Sesame Street for National Rubber Ducky Day. Mr. Pepper did so much for the hotel, but especially for our ducks, that he would make the world's first Duck Master. My name is Anthony Mancioli, the fifth Duck Master since 1940, and in just a few moments it will be my honor to continue our tradition here for you. But first, on rare occasion, I have the honor and privilege of sharing the duties of Duck Master, and today is one of those days. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome with triumphant applause my honorary Duck Masters representing the Sharp family. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Sophie, Chloe, and Hamilton. Come on down. Gentlemen, I want us all to know what it means to be nominated as honorary Duck Master here at this hotel. It is an official station, it has official duties, and as such, it has an official proclamation. Whereas, the daily march of the world-famous Peabody Ducks is a time-honored tradition, begun in 1933 and attended by countless visitors, and whereas, the care and protection of the Peabody Ducks must be attended to on a daily basis. I can only call the persons of high standards and great distinction, and whereas you are such people, be it resolved, that on March 17, 2016, Sophie, Chloe, and Hamilton have been chosen honorary Duck Master. Now, of course, in honor of the ceremony, we have commissioned for them a couple of their very own Duck Master rubbers. Very important. But no Duck Masters are complete, nor can they properly complete their duties without at least one of these honorary Duck Masters. Hey, there you go, sir. You're appropriately dressed. Well done. Now, let's give him one more round of applause. Welcome. In a moment, we're going to use these symbols of office to usher the ducks across the rooftop. We're bringing down the elevators, but at precisely 11 o'clock, the music will call the doors will open. Ducks will march. We do ask, ladies and gentlemen, we're here in the main lobby to remain seated comfortably during the march. We're along the carpet at the entrance to the elevator. But keep those areas clear. Do please resist here to reach out and pet the ducks, throw some coins and things into the fountain. These are wild animals visiting with us after all. Finally, most importantly, ladies and gentlemen, please take as many flash photos as you like. You're all guests with us here today at the Peabody, and this march is for you. On behalf of the ladies, gentlemen, and ducks here at the hotel, I thank you all for joining us. We'll be right back at 11 o'clock.